Thank you very much for inviting me here. Currently, why we look at new ART regimen is because of a new international principle of making the people undetectable. And undetectable means they become untransmittable. So the basic principle has changed only from providing just a care. And it is also care plus prevention. My next slide, please.
Okay.
So the earlier principle was prevention is the only treatment. And when the ART was very expensive or not available, we are all focusing on only preventive aspects and we are saying that prevention is the best treatment, prevention is the best care. But now, treatment is prevention. So if you treat a HIV positive person, that person doesn't transmit HIV anymore. And that is the basic principle, and therefore we have to look at robust ART treatment and covering everybody with ART, those who are HIV positive. So when we look at terminology or phraseology, it was ART, then it became highly active antiretroviral therapy in 1996 when PI was introduced. Then it became totally computer language, mega heart, giga heart. Then it became now combination ART because you combine two or three different classes. Currently, they talk robust ART, that you want to bring down the viral load as early as possible. And it possibly in future, which we'll be discussing in the afternoon, is also individualized ART. So what is newer trends in HIV treatment and HIV management and HIV prevention? Their strategies are basically starting ART earlier than later, treatment as prevention, using PrEP, one or two drugs to prevent infection. Drugs, definitely efficacy of newer drugs, change in the first line drugs, triple therapy, dual therapy, and possibly monotherapy also might come. Changing therapy after viral suppression, TAF versus TDF, efavirenz 600 versus 400, IPT, which has already been discussed, and viral load versus CD4 count, whether we should do both or one, or life expectancy is almost a full life. So what is new and news basically is the WHO's test and treat policy. So all these things have started in last just 1.5 year, 2 years. Introduction of INSTI, which is the integrase inhibitor, dolutegravir in public market. Dolutegravir has been there internationally since last 3 years or 4 years. A single drug tablet regimen with lower dose of efavirenz, that is TLE 400, where efavirenz is only 400 used. TAF has been replacing the TDF, and TAF and FTC competitions have also come. TLD, that is tenofovir lamivudine and dolutegravir, that combination is made available in India and it might be available internationally also, but there are other combinations in pipeline. So when we are talking about the standard of care currently, it is STR, single tablet. Darunavir ritonavir combination has been made available, so it is both 800 plus 100 and 400 plus 50 is available. PrEP or PrEP, which PrEP, PEPSE, 92% of the people with HIV AIDS in the world, they are accessing Indian HIV treatment or Indian ARVs. Injectable ARVs may be coming. There are two studies going to be unraveled in the next couple of months. And vanishing pediatric ARVs. Though there is a still need of pediatric ARVs, but manufacturers are not interested in manufacturing pediatric ARVs because they need a particular batch size. And that much batch size is not required. So therefore, there is a big problem with managing children with HIV. So if you look at what are the drugs available, there are 7 classes of drugs, and out of which NRTI has been one of the first classes, which started in 1985-86 when AZT came. But after that, some of the drugs are getting vanishing because there are better drugs available, safer drugs available. So those drugs with toxicity or those drugs with low potency, they have been phased out. So if you look at all the black drugs which are non-strike, they are available. Green one may be made available. When we are talking about this, we are talking about what is availability for the developing countries. In developed world, everything is available, either through trial or through market. But in our countries, India or Indonesia or most of the Asian countries, we need to look at what is available. And ibalizumab, which is one of the anti-cancer drug, that may be made available, but it is not yet available for us in public market. So when you look at new ART regimen, we have to look at these four drugs or five drugs basically. Abacavir has been available for a long time, but combination of abacavir and lamivudine is recently made available in public market at low cost. So efavirenz 400, dolutegravir, abacavir, lamivudine, darunavir-ritonavir combination, TAF. And what are the heroes currently? They are dolutegravir, darunavir-ritonavir, TAF, and 3TC has been longest in use. So if you look at 3TC from 1987 till today, 3TC has been part of every combination. So what is expected of an ideal ART regimen is basically co-administration with other medications and especially TB treatment. Specific populations, women, children, adolescent, aging population, efficacy, safety, tolerability, there should be minimum adverse drug effect, minimal drug-drug interaction, affordability and global access, potent enough to bring down viral load to undetectable level as early as possible. Pill burden should be lower, either single tablet or minimal pills. No or minimal food restriction, because sometimes we tell patient to take one medicine with a high fat food, one medicine with low fat food, one medicine, so patient get confused. Then suitable dosage convenience, that some people are working somewhere and then you are asking them to take medicine one after breakfast, one after lunch, one after before dinner, it will be impossible. So basically cheaper, acceptable, tolerable ART is essential to increase retention in care and viral suppression to achieve 90-90-90. So when we talk about the magic figures of 90-90-90, they look very big figure, but if you have all these things available, then it is not very difficult to achieve that 90-90-90 target. So currently, medicine patent pool, which is one of the new UN body created last 4-5 years, they are looking at what are the target prices. Target prices means these are the minimum prices they should be there. In addition to that, there will be some taxes and clearance of customs, etc. will be there. So currently, dolutegravir and 3TC is cheapest at $46 per patient per year. So why we are talking about dolutegravir is not because it's a new drug, not because it's only a potent drug, but it is going to be cheapest available. So when you look at what used to happen in 1996-97, when the PIs came and how many tablets patients used to take in 98-99, there were almost 20-25 tablets only for HIV management. Then in addition, vitamins and other co-formulations were required, also treatment for diabetes, hypertension, etc. And then the AZT-3TC nevirapine, they came as a combination, it became two tablet, and thereafter single tablet regimen came. So when we talk about the gift of India to the rest of the world, that is a single tablet regimen. And we have been guided by the principles of anti-TB treatment, where all four drugs, RH, EZ, were combined in one. It's called four COX. So similarly, we requested the companies that I'm asking my patient to take three tablets together with water. Can you make three in one? And even we named that drug called Triimmune. And that was made available, and single tablet is available. So now we are also looking at taking injection once in a month or once in 2 months. So when the virally suppression is achieved for more than 1 to 2 years, we can stop all the treatment and have only one injection in a month or 2 months. So that's possible. So when we look at treatment failure, the treatment failure can be virological failure, immunological failure, and clinical failure. So traditionally, as doctors, we were waiting for clinical failure. If we wait for clinical failure, the patient is already on failing regime for more than 2 to 3 years. So there's a gap of between virological failure to immunological failure, 1 to 2 years, immunological failure to clinical failure, another 2 years. So you have to wait for 3 to 4 years to observe clinical failure. So what is virological failure currently is more than 1,000 copies on 2 consecutive measurements in 3 months with adherence support after first viral load. So basically, if there is good adherence, despite viral load, despite doing regular treatment, if viral load is more than 1,000 copies, it is a virological failure. We must understand what is resistance, because we are going to choose the drugs which are going to be less resistant. Now, develop under suboptimal drug pressure, mutation for reverse transcriptase of protease and integrase genes, permanently archived, because once resistance is there, it will be always there. Some drugs have a low genetic barrier, class cross resistance. Sometimes you make one drug resistant, the other automatically become resistant. If nevirapine resistance is there, efavirenz will be always resistant. And increasing degree if patient continues on failing regimen and transmitted resistant. That is primary resistant, patient is infected with the already resistant virus. So when you look at transmitted drug resistance in different countries, Kenya is supposed to be highest, almost 13%. But Thailand, Indonesia, Philippines, we are not lower. So here's around 5% of the people who are infected, they are infected with the resistant virus by itself. And India is around 5 to 10%. So when you look at primary drug resistant mutations, these are different mutations. And by looking at those mutations, we understand that people are resistant to nevirapine and also efavirenz and sometimes to the first line. So in resistance guideline, they have been clearly mentioned that use non-NNRTI, that is dolutegravir, for initiation of treatment, or you do HIV drug resistance testing, whichever is cheaper. So HIV drug resistance testing is very expensive. In that cost, you can provide treatment with dolutegravir for a patient for 3 years. So that much cost effective. And therefore, national prevalence of pre-treatment HIV-DR to NNRTI is around, wherever it is more than 10%, it is better to start dolutegravir. Now, WHO guidelines, initially for a couple of years, they used to be stagnant. You look at 2002, 3, 6, after 6, 10, after 10, 13. So we were looking at guideline changing only once in 3 years, once in 5 years, that kind of program. But in 2016, the guideline changed, and thereafter there has been change almost every 6 months, every year. And what are those guidelines? Basically, they talk about dolutegravir and efavirenz 400, and that can be preferred in the first line also. So currently, when we have a question, earlier we used to have a question, when to start, what to start, when to change. So now the simple answers are there for each question. When to start, it has become history. There is a test and treat, so there is no need of when to start. What to start, almost the same combo. So whether you talk about Indonesia or India or Thailand, we are starting the same combo. And when to change is now becoming easier because of the availability of viral load, and possibly viral load can be made available at lower cost. So WHO guideline in 2016 said that TDF-3TC and dolutegravir has an alternate regimen. And I'll show you how that shifted from alternative to preferred regimen. So preferred regimen at that time, and still in many countries, is basically TDF-3TC and efavirenz. 3TC can be replaced with FTC. So current first line ART options are efavirenz 400, dolutegravir, tenofovir, alafenamide. These three drugs we are going to look in greater detail. So what is the first line currently? Is TDF or TAF? If TAF is available, use TAF. XTC is 3TC or FTC, any of them. And efavirenz 600. If efavirenz 400 is available, then change that to efavirenz 400. And if dolutegravir can be given, then dolutegravir. And dolutegravir has to be given with either TDF, 3TC. If already 3TC and has been used for longer time, and AZT has been used for longer time, then it's better to give abacavir. So if we look at efavirenz 600, which has been in use for almost 15 to 20 years, what are different issues with efavirenz? And the most important issue has been adverse effects. Now we realize, because at that time we had no option, we were telling people that you take this or don't come. And people were not coming if they were developing adverse side effects, and we were thinking that patient vanished or patient had gone to somewhere else. Now we realize that they had suicidal ideation, they had a lot of depression, they had a lot of intolerance to drug, and therefore they stopped on their own. So we look at all those issues and realize that efavirenz had some problems, and now because of other availability of drugs, then we can get rid of efavirenz and use other drugs. So efavirenz 600 and efavirenz 400 were studied in ENCORE 1 study, where they use 200 milligram, 400 milligram and 600 milligram. Now why 300 was not used? Because at that time efavirenz was available, and till today also it is available either as a 200 milligram or 600 milligram. And they were not making half of the tablet of 600. they could have used 300 and probably that could have been also suffice. So then they realized that 200 were inferior, but 400 and 600, they are almost equal. So the result available from this trial, ENCORE trial, tells that there is no need of using efavirenz 600. So the study outcome suggests that efavirenz 400 is not inferior to efavirenz 600. Adverse event related to study drugs were more frequent with efavirenz 600. Lower dose of efavirenz should be recommended as part of routine care. And at 96 weeks also, findings remain same. So the ENCORE study was encoded at only 48 weeks and it was started in guidelines. But now in 96 weeks also, the results are same. So if you look at 96 week virological response, whether it is efavirenz 400 or 600, there is not much difference. And less of side effects. And at, in one study they found that CD4 count were better with efavirenz 400 than 600. Yeah. So in adverse events and serious adverse event, they found that the patients stopping efavirenz because of treatment related were very high, if it was 600. And patient with adverse event related to efavirenz, if you look at 39% versus 48%, they are much less with 400 milligram. So how did we manage our patient in the pre-TLE 400 era? We used to tell people to take half tablet. It was not mentioned in anywhere in the guideline, and it was also initiated in Thailand, where they used to use lower dosage of AZT. So we made our whole algorithm that patient between 35 to or even up to 50 kg or 40 kg, they were given 50% dose. 75% dose for little bit more weight. So we're asking patient to take one tablet one day and half tablet another day. And priming with half dose for 10 days because initial 10 days intolerance was a big deterrent for people to take efavirenz. So we're asking them to take half tablet for 10 days and then switch to one tablet. And patients on their own, so even if we did not ask, patient on their own were doing that. And patient used to come and say that I'm better after I started half tablet. And virally they were suppressed. So we were on prescription, we're writing one tablet, but patient were taking half tablet. Now, is dose reduction in medicine new? No, it is not new. We have seen in clofenamine maleate, which is sometimes because of sedation, we used to ask them to take half tablet. We have seen didanosine, they had 250 milligram for less than 50 kg, 400 milligram more than 60 kg, stavudine 30 and 40. AZT 600, 400, then 300 in Thailand. Lamivudine 300 in HIV, but 100 milligram in hepatitis B. Similarly, ritonavir, indinavir, darunavir. So, advantage of TLE 400 are basically the pill size is reduced, cost is reduced, side effects are reduced, suitable for low weight patients, and hence overall survival with HIV patient remains high if you use drugs which are easily tolerable. And then we have to look at pharmacokinetics with rifampicin. It can be used with rifampicin also. Earlier they used to say that if you are using in anti-TB, you must use 600. But now the studies show in 2018 that even 400 is good enough. Now looking at dolutegravir in ART9 patients. These are randomized trial which were done. Because of short of time, I'll just rush to the slides because I want to cover many, many more things on dolutegravir. It's a single tablet dolutegravir, which is 50 milligram versus efavirenz 600. And they found that the results were similar and sometimes they were better with dolutegravir. And single tablet with CD4, CD4 also was better with dolutegravir. And single adverse events, this is a single study. Adverse events of dolutegravir and efavirenz, they found that with efavirenz there were more adverse effects. It was also studied with rifampicin, and they realized that in rifampicin, the dosage required of dolutegravir is double, so it is to be given twice a day. And also in pregnancy, the exposure was lower during the second and third trimester, so it is to be given double. We look at competitors at dolutegravir, efavirenz 600 and 400. And we realize that the scores which are given for different parameters or characteristics are much better with dolutegravir, and they were concomitant RMP and pregnancy were looked into for efavirenz. They were 1-1, but now they can be changed to this thing. In Namsal study, they also looked at 400 milligram bifavirase versus dolutegravir, and they found that still 400 can be used, but dolutegravir is better either with 400 or 600. And then they are looking at three more studies in treatment experienced patient: Downing study, Selling study, and Viking study, whether with lopinavir/ritonavir or with raltegravir or in raltegravir resistant patient. So basically, dolutegravir is superior in all settings. So in HIV and pregnancy and ART, only limited data is available. There are big unknowns are there. Timing, whether at what time in pregnancy dolutegravir can be given, and they realize that during conception period it can be harmful, but later on it is not that harmful. So greatest risk is only for conception period, and most studies do not distinguish between first trimester and preconception exposure. And the risk-benefit ratio has to be seen, and the ratio shows that there are more benefits than the risk, so therefore it should be continued. WHO recommendation, therefore, in 2018, they changed to preferred regimen is TLD, that is dolutegravir, and if in adolescent or pre-consumption period, it is TLD 600 or 400. Alternatives are TLD 400, and there are special situation, other drugs are there. So if you look at all other international guidelines, ESCS, DHHS or WHO, dolutegravir has become green zone everywhere. And the special advantage are barrier to resistance, forgiving. Even if person takes three doses in a week, alternate day, still it works. No cross resistance, requires less frequent lab support. Patients who are averse to taking large pills, circumstances like immigration, surgery, patient reports late in pregnancy, discordant couples wanting to conceive PLHIV, this is much superior. And when you need robust response, very bad clinical condition and very poor CD4 count, it works very well. So when we change basically drugs, when is a toxicity or failure, and in pregnancy and situations like active TB. And the TDF has been seen, that is tenofovir, which has been already in use, where it has some problems, particularly in older people, in CKD people, people who are taking other drug for NSAID or hypertension, diabetes. So therefore, they looked at TDF versus TAF, and they found that TAF is much better because rather than TDF 300 milligram, TAF is given as only 25 milligram, and that too when you are using with PI, it is only 10 milligram. So almost 10% to 3% of dose, and it works much better and with less of side effects. So TAF has been already seen in the different combinations with raltegravir, dolutegravir, with quad combination. So basically, when in recommendation, when you are starting ART, when you, even if you say test and treat, it doesn't mean that test and treat in the same day. You need to look at other conditions. Otherwise, you will find people going into IRIS, and IRIS is sometimes more fatal than HIV per se. We also looked at darunavir/ritonavir along with other PIs, and found that darunavir/ritonavir now in 2018, the pill burden has been reduced. Combination is available with ritonavir and also available in generic formulation. So it has become a superior drug among the PI, if you have to use PI. So positioning of darunavir/ritonavir is basically very much simplification. Rather than 600 plus 100 BD, it has come to 800 plus 100 OD. And as a second line agent, and as a third line agent. So it can be used first line, second line, third line. Advantage is basically two older Ds, that is D40 and DDI, they have been replaced with two newer Ds, that dolutegravir and darunavir. And it can be used OD, it is available as a FDC, the cost is also reduced in developing countries, and if resistance is suspected, you can use either dolutegravir or darunavir or sometimes together. And in summary, I would like to tell that if you compare ifavirase 400 with dolutegravir, tenofovir, and darunavir/ritonavir, in treatment-naive patient, it can be used all these four drugs. In treatment-experienced patient, ifavirase 400 should not be used. In pregnancy, they can be used. Ifavirase 400 can be used. In conception, dolutegravir should not be used, but later on it can be used. In TAF, it cannot be used in pregnancy, but RCT is that is randomized control trial is awaited, and darunavir can be used. in TB, HIV co-infection, in darunavir, you have to use with rifabutin, other drugs can be used. And in PEP, efavirenz 400 is not used, TAF is not used, but other can be used. Temprano is already discussed, IPT, and this is a newer drug possibly going to come. So at the end, I would like to tell what Confucius said, that by three methods we may learn wisdom. First is by reflection, which is noblest, but everybody is not noble. Second is by imitation, which is easiest, and that we all of us do. But third is by experience, which is the bitterest. So we have learned in India with lot of experience of going through all these phases, and we realize that this is one of the best thing to do, that we must learn through experience. Thank you.